welcome to my first real versus fake video. I'm going to be doing a couple of videos basically just comparing authentic and inspired products, different kinds like shoes, accessories, like belts, handbags, watches, things like that. Today I'm going to be showing you some Michael Kors watches. I have two fake ones and two real ones. Let's get started. First, I'm gonna show you the package that it came in. Looks like so. It's kind of like this bubble wrap, and inside it had both jewelry boxes, and I already took one out on this side. I'm gonna go ahead and show you that. So starting off, with the packaging, it's very cheap. Look, it's like all discombobulated, and there's a hole right here in the corner. This is broken. Like, what's up with that? I mean, obviously, this is the inspired one. And when you open it, inside they have the watch in this like plastic wrap. Let me put this aside for now. And there's like a little pillow to put your watch on. That's it. That's for the inspired packaging. Now, I'm going to take the watch out of the wrap, see what it looks like. Well, right offhand, I mean, you really can't notice anything different. I mean, I could feel a difference. This one's light compared to a real one. But aesthetically, I mean, they did a pretty good job. Now, one way that I know that, just by examining the watches, that they're fake is by looking at inside of the face of the watch. Sometimes the numbers are messed up or the emblems are crooked. If they're engraved, at times they're not filled in properly, or the numbers, like the 8, sometimes look like a G, or just little things like that. And this one, I mean, they did a very good job inside, except for the letters are connected. I'm not sure if you can see them in here, but either way, at the end of the video, I'll show some pictures, like side-by-side comparisons of the real and fake one, where you can see it. Because on the real Michael Kors watch, let me grab that out. They just have like a slight space in between each letter. And let me just show you really quick, before I compare the watches side-by-side, the packaging of a real Michael Kors watch. See, this is a leather box. It's very sturdy, not flimsy like the other one. And it has Michael Kors engraved on the top. And inside, it also has a little pillow. Excuse that noise. That's my puppy over there growling at the other dog. But here's a little pillow. And inside it has a little booklet, just with instructions of, I guess, how to use the timer and things like that. But definitely a difference compared to the inspired packaging. Okay, and inside it has like this felt material. It's a very nice box. I have another one here. It's also leather. Okay, I'm being bombarded with all types of noises. And it has Michael Kors engraved in it too, and it has this nice stitching all around the box. And inside, here's the watch that I'm gonna compare. Also has a pillow and a little booklet. Okay, so I chose this watch to compare it to because it's actually the most similar one that I had. And this one is a royal blue and kind of like a rose gold color. Mine is a black and gold, but see how they look the same? I mean, the faces are different sizes, but that's okay because, I mean, obviously watches come in different sizes. But Yeah, the only main thing that I see is that. It's just the letters on the face that, you know, one has the connected letters and the other one has the space in between. And again, I'm going to have pictures at the end because you definitely are not, going to be able, to see it there. The only other thing that I see is the four. The four on the black one, the real one, is kind of curved, whereas on the inspired one, it's just a very straight edge. This one doesn't have numbers. So, yeah. And then besides that, the material, this one is kind of like, I don't even know how to describe this. It's very rubbery. It comes up easily here on the side. See, if I just do that, you kind of see how it can pull up very easily. And it's kind of like a sticky material. But for $15, $20, can't really ask for much, right? Whereas this one, it's nicer, thicker, and it doesn't pull up like the other one. Okay, on the sides, there's just a little difference. The finish on the authentic one is very nice. It's flat here, and on the inside, it's a different color gold, but it's flat as well in there. Whereas on the inspired one, the finish isn't the best in between, and then the line in the middle is very thin. But, who's going to come up to you and be like, oh, hey, is that a Michael Kors watch? Let me take it off of you and inspect it. Let me see if it's real or not and, look at the little things. No. And if they do, I don't know. But anyways, yeah. So real and fake. On the sides, these knobs are pretty much in the same distance as the real one. And I meant to say the space in between the knobs are the same. Anyways, and on the inspired ones, they kind of stick out a little bit more than the real one. Here's the inspired one, and then here's the real one. Excuse me. And the buttons are more easy to push down on and pull up on the fake one. Whereas on the real one, you have to push a little harder for it to actually go down, and to pull out, it's a pain. I don't want to really mess up my nails, but you get the point. Okay, so we talked about the material, the face, the sides. One more little thing is that on the middle knob, the authentic one has the MK engraved in it. And they try to do the same thing on the inspired, but it really didn't come out, and it's raised. So there's the MK. And then here is the inspired one. On the clasp, they both say Michael Kors. And the font actually looks the same. This one is a little bit more bigger. The inspired one is bigger than the authentic one, but you could still see it. And when you open it, these metals feel very different. Again, the real one is much more heavier than the fake one. And this is kind of like cheap I don't know what to call this, but yeah. and then on the real one, it has a serial number on the bottom, and this one does not. Now, the back of the watch, I'll grab this one to read. It says all stainless steel, it has the number, then it says 10 ATM, 100 meters, and then it says Michael Kors, like so. And on the inspired one, it also says all stainless steel, has the number 10 ATM, 100 meters, and it says Michael Kors, but it goes straight across. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to see that there. Okay, more weird noises by my dogs. Hey! okay, let me grab the other watch really quick. I don't want to take up too much time. This one's pretty. It's white and rose gold as well. And the letters on this one actually look so much better than the blue one. And you can see the numbers on the inside rim of the face all the way around. And same thing, the buttons, yeah, the material. But again, I mean, they did a really good job on these. So here are, sorry, the fake ones. And these, this one is the real one, and then the one I have on. Yeah. Whether you're buying real ones online and just wanted to know how to differentiate fake from real when you receive them, or if you're, you know, buying an inspired watch just because, I mean, you don't want to spend $150, $200 or more on a real watch, I hope that this was at least a little bit informative for you. I'll probably be selling these on eBay or just giving it to someone. But if you're interested, let me know. but yeah, I hope you had a great day, or actually have a great day. How about both? And hope you enjoyed the video. Take care. Bye. Oh yeah, and stay tuned for the pictures. Bye.